Hi. As you're beginning Unit 2, you're going to be reading about Johann Gutenberg and the development of the printing press, at least in Europe, in around 1450. One reason I wanted to make this little video is just to bring up the whole idea of technology and how it influences design. When this occurs, it's really the first industrialization of design. Up until that point, you had monks basically creating illuminated manuscripts for Bibles, and then really when the Gutenberg press is developed, we begin to see an industrialization of design. Couple of things to consider. Think about how technology influences aesthetics. When Gutenberg was coming up with this, he had to come up with the first font. What did he choose? He decided to make something that looked like it was the script that the Germans, that the German monks had been using to make Bibles so that he could sell more Bibles. Later, when type designers were going to Italy and the Italian Renaissance was starting to use printing, German-looking type wasn't desirable, so they wanted to make something that looked more Roman. And that's where we have something like Times New Roman today. The name New Roman clues you in. It's actually something where the Italians wanted something to look Roman, like Roman characters of 2,000 years ago, or at that time 1,400 years ago. So they developed, Jensen was one of the type designers, the early type designers to do this, developed type that had minuscules that the monks had developed while they were doing the Bible, and combined the minuscules with Roman lettering from, 1,400 years previous to come up with the first type styles. And we see that with Garamond, and then later, down the road, we see it in transitional typefaces and modern typefaces too. But I find it intriguing when you're starting to read about this stuff to think about how technology influences design. Baskerville, who made type a little bit later, one reason why the Baskerville typeface is called a transitional typeface is you have better contrast between thicks and thins in the type letters. Well, that was partly due to technology. They could come up with a stronger alloy that could have a thinner part in the serif, so it was helpful. The alloy made that easier. Also, Baskerville developed his own papers. He came up with a high gloss coated stock that was able to receive the ink better, so he could print with more finesse, more resolution. So the technology influenced the aesthetic, and then the aesthetic turns around and influenced the technology, because people want even sharper contrast. They want it to look even better. So, by the time Bodoni comes along with a modern serif typeface, you have these extreme thicks and thins, partly for aesthetics and partly to say, hey, we can do this. So consider as you look at websites and things that are produced today. I always often refer to the web as today's print revolution. Think about how the technology of the site is influencing the aesthetic. And is that good or bad? Sometimes it's pretty crummy when you look at how some technology is junking up design. But in other cases, it can be really beautiful. So anyway, I just wanted to bring this up as a topic. When you're reading about Gutenberg, it's often easy to get bored and think, this was 600 years ago. But the issue is still the same today. When you're using new technology, how is that influencing your design? And then on the other hand, as you're working in design, what new technological innovations do you want to have? Great example. We have cell phones today, and obviously the iPhone. You're having to design for those phones. Website design, even 6-7 years ago, you weren't concerned so much about that. But now you better be. If you're doing a website for a company, you got to think about how that's going to look on a phone as well as just on a desktop computer. So anyway, it's an interesting topic, and I just wanted to have you think about that while you're reading the unit and beginning to think about how printing influences, or not printing, technology in general influences design.